In the last session, I have shown you an example with the help of direct distance entry method. So let us see one more example using the same method. Now we'll try to see how to create the next figure. Now let me go the same H. Now this we will see how to create using direct distance entry method. So let me start from here, and totally we have all the horizontal and vertical lines. So let me go with line. And here you can pick the first point and switch on the ortho, because we need horizontal and vertical lines. Switch on the ortho and show the direction. And here I need first a line of 4 units. So in this direction I am giving the input as 4 and go with enter. Then vertically towards top I need a line of 3. So let me go with 3 and go with enter. Then horizontally we need a line of 5, this is 5, so you can show the direction and give the input as 5 and go with enter. Then again I need vertically towards bottom, so I am showing the direction towards bottom. I need a line of 3, so go with 3 and enter. Then one more horizontal line towards right side, and again the length of this line is 4, so here you can specify as 4, then go with enter. Then we need vertically a line of 9, so let me go with vertical direction and I am taking here 9. And one more horizontal, I need a line of 4, so go with 4, enter. Then vertical of 3, so go with 3, enter. Then horizontal of 5, so you can go with 5, enter. Then again vertical a line of 3, so you can go with 3, enter. Then one more horizontal of 4, so you can go with 4, enter. Then vertically towards bottom I am taking again 9, so go with 9, enter. Then you can go with escape. So with this the figure is completed. So this is how we can create the figures easily with the help of direct distance entry method. So this is the most common method which we are going to use in the creation of drawings. And if the figures are not possible to create using DDE method, then only you can think of the previous methods which we have seen in the previous sessions. Previous methods are nothing but grid method, absolute method, relative, Cartesian, relative polar. So any one of these four methods we are going to choose if that particular object is not possible to create using direct distance entry method. Now we will see such example. There will be few objects which we cannot create using direct distance entry method. So if it is not possible to create, then you can choose the other methods. And again, regularly we are going to use direct distance method plus relative Cartesian method. So this is the order. The first preference will be given to DDE method. If it is not possible, then you can think about either relative Cartesian or relative polar. Now let us go with one more example here. Now this is the example, and in this figure you can go through the dimensions. This is 3, the overall is 2, 0.75, 1, this is 1.25, this is 0.25, and this is 0.5. So these are the dimensions you can see here. Now because the maximum dimension in this figure is 3, so let me set here once again the limits. Lower left, as I am using same 0, 0. Upper right, let me take 5, 5, because the maximum dimension in that figure is 3. Let me go with 5, 5, then we will go with Z enter, A enter. Now let me go with line, pick the first point. Then here we need a horizontal line of 3 units, so you can show the direction and you can go with 3, enter. Then we need vertically a line of 1.5, so directly you can show the direction and you can go with 1.5, enter. And after reaching this point, now we have to draw an inclined line, and this inclined line is not possible to create using direct distance entry method. The reason is, here we don't know the exact direction, plus even we don't know the length of that line. So this inclined line can be created with the help of relative Cartesian method. The reason is, though it is inclined, here it didn't specify the length, even it didn't specify the angle. So because we don't know the length, we don't know the angle, we cannot go with relative polar method. We can go with relative Cartesian method. So from here, if I want to reach this particular point, then I have to specify the x and y values. So from here to here, I have to move in x negative and in y positive. So I can specify the distance as minus 0.75, and this y is nothing but 0.5 because the overall is 2. From that we have to subtract 1.5, so remaining will be 0.5. So I am going to take here the coordinates as minus 0.75 comma 0.5. So let me specify here at the rate, because it is related to Cartesian, I am going at the rate. From there, minus 0.75 comma 0.5, then go with enter. So this is the inclined line. Then again, the next one is horizontal, which you can create using DD method. So directly you can show the direction, left side, then give the input as 1 and enter. Now after reaching again this particular point, we have to draw one more inclined line. So this is the inclined line, and again this inclined line is not possible to create using DD method. So let us use the same relative Cartesian method. And now if you see here the dimensions, x is 1.25 because the overall is 3, and from here to here it is 1.75, so the remaining will be 1.25. So x is 1.25 and y is 0.75 because the overall height is 2, whereas from here to here it is given as 1.25, so remaining will be 0.75. And if you see about the direction, we are moving in the negative of x as well as in the negative of y. So both should be negatives. So let me go with at the rate minus 1.25 comma minus 0.75. So we got that line. Then again the remaining lines are vertical and horizontal lines, which you can create using DD method. Then the length of this line is 0.5. So you can show the direction towards bottom and specify 0.5. Then I need horizontally one more line, and the length of this horizontal line is 0.75. The reason overall is 3, from that you have to subtract 2.25, so remaining will be 0.75. So specify 0.75. Then vertically I need one more line of 0.5, so go with 0.5. Then again horizontally towards left side you can go with 0.75. Then towards bottom we have to take 0.25. So specify here 0.25, then go with escape. So this is how we can create the figures by mixing the methods. So whichever method you feel better, directly you can apply that method to create the objects. And it is not compulsory to create using only one method. You can mix the methods and easily we have to complete the drawing. So this is about the different methods and the combinations. Now after this, now next we'll see about the selections. Selections are nothing but how to select the object. In general, we can select the object in three ways. For example, let me draw here few lines. Now if I want to select any one of these lines, directly I can select it with the help of the cursor. Take the big box onto that line and select it. Now if I want to select this bottom horizontal, I can select it and I can go with delete or move, whatever I want to do here. So like this, one by one you can select. This is called direct selection. Instead of direct selection, if I want to select all the lines at a time, then I can take the help of any one of the two windows. And in that, the first one is called a window, an ordinary window. And second one is known as crossing window. Now if you want to select the objects using window, you can pick a point on the screen, and with respect to that first point, you have to move towards right side. So if you move towards right side, then you are going to have a window like this, which is filled up with blue color, and this is called ordinary window. And using this window, you can select the objects. But here there is one condition, and the condition is, what are the objects we are trying to select? They should be completely inside the window. For example, now if you see here, horizontal line and vertical lines are inside the window, whereas the bottom horizontal is partially placed in the window. But now if I click here the second point, it won't select this third bottom horizontal line. So what are the objects are inside that window, it is going to select them. So this is about an ordinary window, and then we have a crossing window, and if you want to get the crossing window, you can get it by clicking a point on the screen, and with respect to that point, now you have to move towards left side to get that crossing window. And this is called a crossing window, which is filled with green color, and even if you see, we have a dashed font. And if this crossing window just crosses an object, that object is going to be selected. It is not compulsory to lie inside, just that crossing window is touching the object, then it will select all those objects. So these are the three important selection methods.